Hi everyone, this is Suresh, Assistant Professor, Department of CSE, BBC ITS, Amalapuram. Today, I would like to explain exception handling. Before going to exception handling, let me explain some basics about exception handling. Generally, while we are compiling a program or running a program, we may get two types of common bugs. First one is logic errors and the second one is syntactic errors. So what is logic errors and what is syntactic errors? The logic errors occurs due to poor understanding of the problem and the solution procedure to that particular problem. And the second one is syntactic errors may rise or occur due to poor understanding of the language itself. So these are the common bugs while we are running a program or compiling a program. And coming to the exceptions are runtime anomalies that a program may encounter while executing. Anomalies means unusual conditions. Anomalies might include the conditions such as divisible by zero or accessing to an array out of its bounds or out of its range and running out of memory or disk space. These are the unusual conditions while we are running a program or executing a program. Actually, there are two types of exceptions are there. First one is synchronous exceptions and the second one is asynchronous exceptions. Coming to synchronous exceptions, these are the errors such as out of range index and overflow and divisible by zero. And coming to asynchronous exceptions, these are the errors that are caused by events beyond the control of the program, such as keyboard interrupts or hardware failure. So, the mechanism of exception handling performs the following four tasks. Actually, exception handling mechanism is used to handle synchronous exceptions only. Exception handling is not going to handle asynchronous exceptions. Exception handling mechanism is used to handle the exceptions or unusual conditions such as synchronous exceptions. So, actually, the mechanism of exception handling performs the following four tasks. The first one is find the problem or hit the exception. The key term of this is try. And the second one is inform that an error has occurred, means throw. And the third one is receive the error information, that means catch. And the fourth one is take necessary or corrective actions, that means handle. Let me explain a small program why we need actually exception handling. So, as we already know that compiler, what it is going to do is it compiles or translates high level language code to low level language code or source code to target language code, target code. And it again retranslates target generated output to source code. And coming to Java is both compiled and interpreted language. That means interpreted means executing line by line. The program Java compiler executes or Java interpreter executes line by line of the code. So if we observe the given program or sample program, I have written some code here. In this code, I have taken a integer variable a and assigned a value of 10, and I have taken an integer variable, another variable b, I assigned 5 as the value, and I have taken third variable c and assigned a value 5. So here I am trying to perform two operations. I am finding out x and y. X equals to a by b minus c. In second line, in next line, y equals to, I am performing a by b plus c. If we observe the code, here I am trying to perform a by b minus c. That means 10 by 5 minus 5. That means 10 by 0. Actually, here there is a chance to raise exception. Rise of exception. Why we are getting exception here? Why we are having an exception here? Because I am trying to do or I am trying to divide an integer value with a zero. which we cannot perform. We cannot divide an integer or a value with a zero. Hence, we will get an exception here. So, when there is an exception in this line, particular line, automatically the program stops its execution here itself. Though I have retained the remaining lines very correctly, the program stops its execution here because Java is interpreted language and it is executes line by line of the program. So, if I write the remaining lines correctly, but the program cannot execute the remaining lines or rest of the program because there is an exception here in this particular line. So, to avoid this problem, we are having exception handling mechanism. Though there is an error in a program, it informs that there is an error in the program and it executes the remaining lines as it is. So, exception handling mechanism is used to see, as I already told you, that mechanism performs the following four tasks. Exception handling mechanism performs the following four tasks. Find the problem, inform that there is an error occurred, and receive the error information, take the corrective actions. See, here I am having exception handling mechanism. See, in exception handling, there are two blocks. First one is try block and the second one is catch block. What a try block consists of? Try block consists of block of statements which there is a chance to raise exception. Try block detects and throws exceptions. See, try block throws the exception object. And what a catch block is going to do is, catch block catches and handles the exception. So, try block is having the statements or block of statements which may raise an exception. What catch block is having the statements of or block of statements to handle the exception. So, here the syntax. So, try block. Here is the try block. Try is the keyword. And I am having a statements, see, block of statements which detects and throws exceptions. So, throws exception. So, try block is going to throw the exception. And catch block is having the syntax, catch is a keyword and exception type. And here we are having exception object. So, in catch block, it consists of block of statements that handle the exception. So, this is the syntax of exception handling. So, here we are having try block and catch block. What try block consists of? Block of statements which detects and throws exceptions. And catch block is having block of statements that handle exception. So, this is the sample program of exception handling. See, I am taking a class demo, public static void main, string args. Here, I am taking the same example program, a equals to 10, b equals to 5, c equals to 5. And again, I am taking two variables of integer type, x, comma, y. So, I have written try block in try block a statements which may raise an exception. Means, I am performing some x, I am calculating x as x equals to a by b minus c. That means 10 by 5 minus 5. So, here I am getting 10 by 0. Cannot divisible by 0. So, here we are having an exception. So, automatically what catch block is going to do is, as I already told you that the syntax of the exception handling, exception type is arithmetic exception because we are trying to divide a variable or a value with a 0. So, this is arithmetic exception and here this is the exception object. So, in this exception, I am trying to perform or print system.out.println divisible by 0. So, divisible by 0, automatically when try block raises an exception, automatically it throws some exception object, that is arithmetic exception E. So, here I am trying to print something and the catch block prints the statement divisible by 0. So the next statement is y equals to a by b plus c. That means 10 by 5 plus 5. That means 10 by 10. That equals to 1. So the next statement is system dot out dot println y equals to y. So actually what we are going to perform is, though there is an error, that means cannot divisible by 0, the exception handling mechanism gives us the information about the error. That means necessary steps to handle the exception, and the rest of the code of the program is executes as it is. That means we are getting y equals to 1 as the result. See, the sample output is divisible by 0 because we are trying to perform divisible by 0 and y equals to 1. Okay? Thank you.